Melissa is one of the original editors and reviewers of new interactive curriculum called What's in Your World.
There's great information and there's fun information. It's not just just hardcore science facts.
At a Bugs with an Attitude workshop, Sage Fitch used activities from What's in Your World to help teachers integrate biocontrol activities into Utah core requirements. What's in Your World combines student publications and teacher guides with interactive online media and activities that number more than there are days in a school calendar year.
I haven't had a chance to actually do any of the actual stuff in my classroom or anything like that, so that would make a big difference. But being able to understand it, it's very easy. It's very well put together. It flows very easy. And it was nice because the person I explained it to had a lot of experience of already even doing some things with that. And so it's going to fit very easy in her classroom. And I think it'll be wonderful for her because she can just take it right now and literally use it next week in her classroom.
A grand idea would be to somehow incorporate this whole workshop into an exhibit at the Living Planet Aquarium. Have an insectary where we are raising the insects and just have some big exhibit kind of detailing the problem, how it's being handled, how it's being controlled, the success stories, before and after pictures, and just have it all so the public can come and learn about it.
And then at my school, it'd be nice to be able to know, because we're pretty close to the Forest Service up on there in PG Hill there, and be able to see what is actually up a couple of those canyons there, and then depending upon what's there, be able to see what we could then set up at the school, whether it's the Dalmatian toad flax, which you were talking sounded one that was able to set up and do.
Teachers are using What's in Your World in different ways. Jamie Greer of the Department of Agriculture blends What's in Your World and Bugs with an Attitude for Nevada Teacher Trainer Workshops. Fish and Wildlife Service Region 6 staff and teachers elevate caring for mountain wilds to wetland wonders in field trips to Bear River Migratory Bird Refuge and Hardware Ranch Wildlife Management Area. Brittany Ellis uses the interactive tools and activities for a second grade community service learning project.
And they have all the pictures of all the weeds in them. Everybody gets one.
What do you say, second grade, when
thank
you get something?
Thank you. Whoa.
John Councilman of Gallatin National Forest helps second graders learn how to use GPS units.
CT for Canada Thistle.
Okay. 5 0 4 1
Okay, all right. It's my turn to have the GPS.
Curly, do you want to do a GPS? Okay.
Okay. Hey, you guys, good job. Let's go find another plant.
Can't do it.
Okay. Can you get it okay?
We collected the UTM coordinates, and so they wrote them on in their notebooks for every different weed patch. So the CT stands for Canada Thistle. And then I had to translate those numbers and try and figure out, you know, what the numbers were and get those all on a spreadsheet and enter them then into the ArcGIS mapping program. So this is an actual map printed out, and it's got the background aerial photography and then the species and points all plotted along where they found the different weed infestations.
This one, Aiden. This
one is for me.
Wow. Yeah.
One, two, three.
Right, get goofy.
Everybody say weeds.
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 Yeah. noxious weeds come from Europe and Asia, and when they move into North America, they're able to take over because two really important things are missing. What are those two important things, those controls that are missing?
Disease and bugs.
The disease and the bugs that eat them. Okay.
And by the way, some dogs are able to sniff out the noxious weed, the training dog.
Yes. When you're out on your own, what should you do if you see a noxious weed?
Tell a grown-up.
You can tell a grown-up. What else can you do?
You can use that spray.
You can use that spray.
Pull it.
Lawn mow it.
Some of them, yep. Desi?
You can also use the disease or the bug.
Ooh, those bugs, those biocontrols, right?
Yeah, we're going to see
the biocontrols that
Madison.
We're going to bring here.
Well,
the biocontrols.
All of the resources that you've heard about on this film are available at Biocontrol in Your Backyard on the web and is available for your use. And please go and visit it and let us know what you think.
These teachers are a wonderful source. If we can get them together, if they would like to work with a federal agency or state agency, we can help them start insectaries, we can help them go out and map, we can help them with their students, with their curriculums, with projects that they might want to work on. We're there to help them and we hope that they will contact us.
Find all of these resources to increase the use of biological control on the internet at wiki.bugwood.org/biocontrol in your backyard.